Much better. I mean, you got it done pretty quick, pretty easy, right? How'd you feel in there?
I felt great. I felt relaxed finally. You know, first fight was on 10 days notice. You know, I didn't have much of a camp. I didn't have a camp at all. No sparring or anything like that. So to be able to have a full camp, be comfortable, I was confident. That's a big thing. I was confident there. I was able to come forward, post some heat, and I knew the takedown would be there eventually. I didn't want to feel so quickly, but I didn't think I got punched, you know, so it was easy to get that takedown. It was there. Timing was felt great. Everything was on point. And, softened him up with a couple lefts, and then the rear neck snuck in there real easy for me. So it was a great feeling.
You had a full camp, but you didn't have a full camp for him, right? I mean, and you had a pretty, you know, brave face coming into the fight. You're like, hey, no big deal. It happened on short notice. It's fine. But, I mean, how difficult is it to go into a UFC fight with opponents changing just days out?
It wasn't too much of a difference for me. They were both orthodox. I felt like my wrestling was obviously going to be better. And all three of those opponents, I felt like my wrestling was going to be a lot better. So I was comfortable with that aspect of it. I'm glad they didn't change from orthodox to southpaw. That's a whole different mind game there, a whole different, you know, strategy there. So the whole camp, the whole strategy is almost the same. Come forward, let's take you down, let's wrestle, see where it goes from. So it was a great fight.
Aggressive with the choke. I mean, did you have a feeling that was going to be there? It looked like you, you know, once you got the position, you weren't going to give it up.
Yeah. It was kind of surprising. It went in pretty deep. Once I had it, I was like, oh, okay, we got this. So I cinched up tight and squeezed as hard as I could, and he tapped for me, so that was good. I didn't think he was going to tap. I thought he was just going to go out and out on the shield. So it was a good feeling when I felt that hand hit me. I was awesome. Ecstatic.
Very nice. What's the plan from here? I mean, are you hoping to get booked quickly? Is there a card that makes sense for you coming up? What's next?
There's a Wichita card. I'm an hour and a half away from there, but that's quick. So I promised my coach I wouldn't take another round. Fight again. I need to go out there and learn. I need to get soaked up, and because I just moved out to California in October, so I've only had to train full time for 3 months now, 4 months. So I'm able to train full time, concentrate on my fight, not work, and then fight. I'm just working on fighting.
What were you doing before?
I'm a friend. I was building houses.
Really?
So I'd work all day, 10 hours a day, take care of my daughter, and then trying to get in the gym.
So this was the first camp ever that you did not do that?
No, I've always come out for my camps. I've been blessed with a job that allowed me to come out here for my camp. So I've always came out six to whatever it was I could get out, you know, on my previous fights. Obviously, the bottom line was 10 days notice. So I didn't have any camp. I came out to California and sprinted. I was sparring or nothing, no timing. So it was and I got the UFC. So it was a big throw in there right off the bat. So it was good. It was good to have a full camp. I felt comfortable, confident. That's the biggest thing. I was confident in there. And that's, I'm confident. I'm moving forward and I'm in shape. I'm going to tough dude the best way.
Thanks. Thank you, sir. Congratulations. Okay.